All life on Earth has only one goal, to survive. By passing on life, the code of life, from generation to generation.
I'm really interested in basic science. I started with chemistry, then moved into biology, and I'm focusing on RNA for the last 20 years. RNA is ribonucleic acid. It's a central molecule in life. It was at the origin of life. It's in RNA viruses.
And that makes RNA essential for the transmission of life.
And this is what I'm fascinated about, how you can control RNA.
And that also happens to be his special talent. The German biochemist Thomas Tuschl is a star of the genetic engineering world. His work has established the basis for RNA interference, a method that enables the silencing of any disease-causing genes. It's a medical revolution.
We started our basic research in, I think, 1999, and then continued it when I moved to Germany in 2001, where our major publications. Our basic discoveries in RNA interference were patented in Europe. They happened still when I was at Max Planck for biophysical chemistry in Göttingen.
In 2014, Thomas Tuschl was nominated for the European Inventor Award.
RNA interference is a cellular process to silence genes. And I was really happy to receive this from Europe because it's been such a long time that I haven't been working in Europe. And then the inventions was licensed to Alnylam, where I'm one of the co-founders together with other scientists.
Finally, in 2018, Alnylam launched the first drug to be based on RNA interference.
And so it took basically 20 years to translate a basic discovery into actual medicines. After we have made so much progress with RNAi and were able to move the technology into a company, I got interested again in doing more basic research. And the innate immune system became a new interesting area for me.
The body is attacked in many ways by all kinds of different intruders. Among them, viruses. Essentially, they only consist of RNA or DNA, the genetic code for their propagation. They cannot proliferate by themselves, however. To do so, they have to place their RNA or DNA inside the cytosol of a host cell. Because viruses, too, have just one goal, to survive. And that's precisely what our body's built-in defense, our innate immunity, wants to prevent.
And we started to work on an enzyme that is specialized on recognizing cytosolic DNA, which is called cGAS.
The function of the enzyme is at least as complex as its name. In a viral infection, cGAS is capable of detecting foreign DNA that has been smuggled into the cell. As soon as the cGAS binds to the foreign DNA, an intracellular signaling molecule known as second messenger is produced. And this triggers the production of interferon.
So cGAS is one of the few molecules that we know when we activate them directly lead to interferon production.
Interferon is an important process in our innate immunity. It initiates responses that defend us against viral or bacterial infections.
The reason why I'm so fascinated about these sensors is that they are sometimes a good thing because they alert your immune system that there's invasion and you mount your arms that you have, you mount your immune system. But there are also autoimmune diseases where too much of an immune response causes diseases that lead to organ failure and fibrosis. Understanding how these sensors work and being able to turn them on and off was a really fascinating research area for me. So cGAS has been shown to be an important anti-inflammatory drug target, and we wanted to develop an inhibitor for this enzyme.
Tuschl's team scanned through a library of almost 300,000 small molecules, and finally they found an inhibitor for C-gas.
We also were able to patent the chemical matter of this inhibitor.
And once again, his inventions and patents have led to the foundation of a company, Ventus Therapeutics.
And I'm very proud that I'm able to contribute our expertise again into a commercial setting so that hopefully in less than 20 years, that's how long it can take sometimes, we will be able to have inhibitors for new inflammatory diseases.